Welcome to Paws for Adoption. I'm Lisa Smith, the director at the Humane Society Waterville area, and we'd like to show you a little bit about who we have up for adoption today, as well as provide some information for you today about finding and recovering your missing pet. Everybody, we've got Star with us today. Whoop. Star, who wants a tennis ball? Who is a good girl? Star is a 5-year-old shepherd mix. She is a great dog. She loves kids. She loves family. She loves treats. Who wants a cookie? Who wants a cookie? Star, can you sit? Good girl. Yes, good girl. Star can sit. Yeah. Star is not a fan of cats, or maybe she likes cats too much. And she's selective with other dogs. So the perfect home for Star in our mind is one who doesn't have any other dogs, but who may have kids with high energy that would love a dog to play with. Like tennis balls? Huh? You like tennis balls? Who is a good girl? You get that? Yeah. Who is a good girl? She's a lot of fun. Can you sit? What else do you know how to do? Can you sit? What is that? Good girl. Good girl. Can you give paw? Yay! Star can give paw. Yeah. She's a lot of fun. Star, like all the dogs at the Humane Society in Waterville, has been spayed before she goes. She is microchipped. She's vaccinated with distemper and rabies vaccine and kennel cough. She's also been tested for heartworm and the tick-borne diseases like Lyme disease, Ehrlichia, anaplasma. And so she's fully vetted and ready to go. And once you adopt a dog from the Humane Society in Waterville, you also are entitled to a free veterinary visit with one of our area participating veterinarians. So it's a really good deal. And I don't know, the price that you pay certainly is a low price to get the love and the loyalty of a great dog like Star. You say hi. Yes. We've got Isabel with us today. Isabel came to the shelter when her owner became homeless and couldn't care for her anymore. She's about 2 or 3 years old. She's a female pit bull mix. She's a real couch potato. She loves to lay around and eat. Isabel loves to go for car rides, and she's just a great family member. She'd prefer to go to a home that doesn't have cats. She is not a fan of cats, and she's not a big fan of other female dogs. This little dog wants to be the queen bee of the house, so she'd be best to be an only dog in the household. She also loves car rides, and she loves to go for walks. Carolyn, how's she do on the leash today?
She's done pretty well. She's a very sweet girl. She likes to stop and sniff and get a pat. She's a nice girl on the leash. Maybe a little strong, but she's also excited.
Isabel
is a good snuggler.
She's a snuggler. Isabel is spayed. She's been vaccinated, and she's ready to go with the Humane Society of Waterville area. So we've got Jack here today. Jack is an American Bulldog. He's about 4 years old. Jack's been neutered and he's up to date on his vaccinations. He is a snuggle bug. Jack loves to go for car rides. He came to us as a stray. We were never able to figure out exactly who owned Jack. Nobody ever came back to claim him. But what we found out about Jack while he's been here is that he's pretty good with other dogs. He loves female dogs. If there are other male dogs in the household, he'd want to be the dominant dog. Isn't that right? Yeah, you love girlfriends. Yes, you love girlfriends. What do we know about cats? We don't think Jack would do well with cats. We want to keep the kitty safe, so we're going to say no cats in a household for Jack. But he seems to be a really good family dog. He's a guy who would love to crawl into bed with you and snuggle at night, lay on the couch and watch movies with you, probably even share that bowl of popcorn.
Good girl. Good girl.
Lay it down. This is Maya. She's a beautiful 4-year-old yellow Labrador Retriever. I think she's a mix. She may be purebred. Let's see what we've got. She is a mix, but she looks for all the world like a purebred. And she certainly has the fixation on cookies like a regular lab. Yes, she is a good girl. Maya, shake. Paul? Good girl. I knew you could do it. Good girl. Maya is totally housebroken. She's spayed and vaccinated. Can you say hi? Can you say hi? Yeah. Who loves the ball? Maya's favorite game, like most labs, is playing with the ball, although it doesn't look like it right now. No, it doesn't. Maya's also crate trained, and she loves to ride in cars. Maya's not a fan of small children, but she'd do well in a family that has children ages 10 and above. She'd make a great family dog. Karen, what about cats with Maya? She's good with cats? Yeah, we understand that Maya is very good with cats. And possibly not other dogs?
Yeah, she's dog selective.
Some dogs can be Maya's friend, and some dogs not. So it's all up to Maya in that category.
She's very sweet.
She's really sweet. She's an excellent, excellent dog. How does she walk on the leash? Very good on the leash. So if you're looking for a nice addition to your family and you've been looking for a lab, especially a yellow lab. A lot of times those are hard to come by. Why don't you come out to the Humane Society and check out Maya? She'd be happy to meet you. Won't ya? Can you sit? This is Mickey. Mickey looks like a big dog, but Mickey is really just a puppy. And he's super exuberant. Who is a good boy?
Okay, Mickey, come here.
He's like, I know that there is a cookie in that hand. Mickey's about 11 months old, and he is enthusiastic about everything. Mickey loves other dogs. Mickey loves cats. Mickey loves kids. Mickey would love to go to somebody's house and be their best friend.
Mickey.
What?
Mickey.
Who? Where? What is that? What is that? Mickey's great with car rides. He's been neutered and vaccinated. Mickey's been microchipped, and he's up to date on his deworming, and he's been tested for heartworm and the tick-borne diseases, and he's negative with that. Mickey's available for adoption at the Humane Society Waterville area, and I'd love to have you come out and check Mickey out to see if he's a possibility to take home. Mickey, Pookie's a good boy.
So Mickey would be an excellent candidate for obedience class because he's really smart and he's very eager to please and he's very active. And obedience training is great with all of his qualities. And it's also a really nice way to improve and strengthen the bond between a dog and his or her owner because it helps you develop a relationship. I think
a relationship with a dog's tail.
Yeah. I think that Mickey has lots of puppy energy, but would be a great candidate for obedience and would really thrive with all that socialization because he's just such a good boy and he wants to be a lap dog, but he's a big boy who needs just a little bit of manners. So.
We've done a safer behavior test on Mickey. We have someone who comes and works with us to test some of our dogs. And Mickey scored a perfect one, meaning he has a lot of good personality traits. He's friendly, he takes surprises well, he's good with other dogs, he does not have any resource guarding or food aggression. He's just a really good all-around family dog.
Go ahead.
We've got Jayla here. Jayla is a four-year-old hound dog. She's a plot hound, probably a plot hound mix. And Jayla came to us probably 4 or 5 months ago when she was pregnant and had a litter of 9 puppies. So she did a fabulous job of raising all those puppies. They've all been adopted. And at this point, we just have Jayla remaining. Jayla, can you sit? What? She's, no, but I can eat cookies. Yeah. Jayla loves to ride in cars. She's a super, super nice dog. She's absolutely crazy about kids. She can be calm, and she can also be very playful. So if you're looking for a couch potato, Jayla can be a couch potato at times, and then she can also jump up and play with the family and go on family outings. Like a lot of hounds, Jayla has a beautiful hound voice. Don't you? Can you say something in hound for us? Yeah. Probably not a good bet with cats, although we have tried her around the cat cages here. She seems to be fine. Definitely not a candidate to go home with rabbits. She does like other dogs. Jayla has been spayed since she's been back from having her puppies, and she's fully vaccinated at this point and tested for the tick-borne diseases and heartworm, and she's negative. And she's ready to go. We'd love to have you come out and meet Jayla. Karen, is there anything else that we can say about Jayla today? The techs love Jayla. She's a real favorite around here. Who is a pretty girl? Can you say hi? Can you say hi?
She's beautiful.
So I wanted to talk a little bit about helping animals who are lost get reunited with their owners. It's something we deal with every day here at the Humane Society of Waterville area. Not only do we take in owner surrenders, but we take in a lot of stray animals. I would guess that probably 70% of the animals that find their way to our doors are here without a known owner. So it makes it tough for us for a number of reasons. One, we spend a lot of time trying to reunite found pets with owners that we don't know who they are. The other thing is that we also then don't know anything about those animals if they are unclaimed when we put them up for adoption. So we're sort of guessing until we have spent enough time with the dog or cat to know its personality. So if someone cannot afford for one reason or the other, either financially, they're moving, allergies, whatever the reason, there's no judgment in surrendering an animal. If you have an animal that you've loved and can no longer provide a home for it, for any number of very good reasons, we encourage you to call the shelter and try to schedule an appointment to bring that animal in to surrender it, providing all of the necessary information that we look for, such as veterinary records so that we don't duplicate vaccinations. Also, personality quirks, what your animal loves, what your animal doesn't like, all of that is good information for us to know, and that's information that we don't get with a stray animal. One of the things I'd like to talk to you folks about today is ways to put identification on your pet so that if it does go missing, you're more likely to get the animal sent back to you either by a local concerned citizen or animal control police officer. There's a lot of different ways to do it. There's the old-fashioned way, which is a collar. This happens to be a collar for cats. A lot of people are very hesitant to put collars on cats because they fear that they will be strangled. And actually, if you look at the research, there are very few cases of that happening. And yes, every once in a while it does, which is why many of the cat collars these days are breakaway cat collars. So if the cat gets hung up somewhere, the collar will pop off so that there's no harm done to the kitty. Then for identification on your collar, it can be just as simple as taking a permanent marker and writing your phone number on the collar, because a collar alone won't help get that cat back to you. You can eventually identify the cat by its collar color, but your phone number, and there's not going to be any identification that will help someone call you. Other ways of getting a cat back to you or a dog are having personal engraved identification tags. There are a number of pet stores locally who have engraving machines right on site, as does the Humane Society here in Waterville. So if you would like to pick up a cat collar and engrave a custom tag, we have these tags for sale at the front desk, and you can pick up both collars and tags right here at the shelter. It's interesting to note, being here in the shelter, we have a lot of stray cats that come in, and only 4% of the stray cats that come into the shelter are actually ever reclaimed by their owners. People give up looking too soon. It takes a while for a stray cat to actually come out of hiding to be able to be found and brought to the shelter. And 90%, 99% of the cats that come in with no collars and no identification, no microchips. So another very good reason to make sure that you have identification on your cat at all times. All of our dogs and cats go out with identification. The cats, we have a lost cat recovery package that we sell, which includes a microchip, a collar, and an ID tag for $10. You can pay for that at your time of adoption. And I wanted to talk a little bit about microchipping and how a microchip works. A microchip is a tiny, tiny little electronic device about the size of a grain of rice, and actually one fits right into the end of a hypodermic needle, and that's how we insert it into an animal's scruff, just under its skin, is on the end of the hypodermic needle. So, and I was just going to show the what that looks like. It's a hypodermic needle with the microchip already in it. It goes right under the scruff of the animal. And then anyone with a wand, like when you check out at the grocery store, there's a wand that you read the barcode of your groceries. We have certain types of electronic wands that will read microchip numbers. So we scan every stray animal that comes into the shelter. Animal control officers all over the country do this, as well as other shelters. So if an animal comes to us with a microchip, we can see what that identification number is, and then we track back on a database to see who that microchip is registered to. So if you come to the shelter, you can pay for a microchip, and we will microchip the public's animals. Our adoptive animals here are already microchipped, and they go out with the adopter registered to the microchip. So that's how a microchip works. Animals will also get a tag that they can wear that has their microchip number on the tag, which you can have in addition to your ID tag. There are other kinds of tracking devices, such as GPS collars, that you can purchase. There's a new one coming out. It's fairly small. It's a little tracking device that you can hang on your dog's collar. And I think there's applications that sync up to your smartphone so that you can, at any point, look down and you can find where your dog is located. We don't have that technology yet, but it's out there. And it's fairly affordable, I think $70 or $80. So. If you want to be able to see where your dog or cat is at all times, you can invest in a GPS tracking device. But anyway, all sorts of information so that you can put identification on your animal, as simple as just even duct tape and a phone number written on your animal's collar to engrave tags to microchip. It's very important. Identify your pets, even the ones that don't go outside, just in case that cat escapes out the door. You want to make sure when someone finds it, they can get that pet back to you. Key. Draco, who is a good boy? Who is a good boy? So who do we have here, Alyssa?
This is Draco. Draco was found in an abandoned apartment building. He came in with another cat who was equally as hefty. So they weren't for wanting of food, that's for sure. Draco was just added to this room today. This is our confident cat room. These cats tend to get along really well with others, but they also are fine with not ruling a place. You know, they live in pretty good harmony in here.
nobody's really established themselves as the dominant cat in here. They all just kind of live peacefully.
How old do you think Draco is?
Get your hands on.
I would say Draco's probably 6 or 7 years old. It looks like he's been pretty well taken care of until recently, when maybe his last owners just couldn't find a resource for him, didn't know what to do. Maybe they had to move or were evicted, and they just kind of panicked and left him behind.
Looks like Draco does pretty well with other cats. For being his first time in the room, sometimes there's a little bit of little turf war. Everybody's sort of establishing their spot here. But he seems like he's doing pretty well.
Yeah, Draco came to us and was already neutered. We did keep him in the surgery suite for a little while just because it's one of our quieter caged rooms. And it gave him just a little chance to adjust to the idea that there were other foreign cats here that he hadn't spent much time with. And get him used to the idea and the smells and sounds and the goings on at the shelter. And I really think that was a crucial step in getting him onto the adoption floor, was slowly introducing him to the shelter environment.
Okay. Well, it seems like he'd just be a good all-around cat in a home environment. He could get along with other cats. Do we know about dogs?
Without having the owners had surrendered him to us, we really don't know what his living situation was like before he came here. I think that he would have no problem establishing himself in a house full of dogs. I think that he would let them know pretty quickly whether he was pleased or not. So I don't think that would be a problem.
Excellent. Well, he's beautiful. He's a medium hair buff tabby. And
I'm sure he's got a little bit of Maine Coon to him, too.
And possibly a little Maine Coon. He's got some little swirly hairs underneath there. Hi, handsome. Who do we have here?
This is Absalom. Absalom was a similar situation where he was just kind of found roaming in a building, and nobody has claimed him. And he is just the sweetest thing I've ever laid eyes on. He's very friendly. He's done nothing but purr since he got here. He's just a very sweet boy. I don't know that he would do well in a house with dogs just because he is very quiet, he keeps to himself, he's not as assertive as some of the other cats are, so it might make him more of a target with more rambunctious dogs. Maybe a smaller dog would be okay.
Is he claiming you?
Yes, maybe up to 20-25 pound dog, something where he wouldn't feel as threatened, where he could hide a little more easily and kind of show that he's okay with it.
Oh, what a love bug.
He's a good boy.
Anybody looking for a lap cat should consider Absalom. He's beautiful.
Yes, he's a good boy.
And looking around the room, I can see that we've got a lot of black or black and white cats right now.
We do. Unfortunately, there's a stigma with black cats and black and white cats that, you know, they're not as good, or there's a superstition, whether it's conscious or subconscious.
Or they tend to be overlooked because there's not a lot of quote-unquote personality in their markings for a solid black cat.
Honestly, I think it's quite the opposite. I think they're usually overwhelmed with personality.
I found the same thing when you really get to know black cats. I've known a lot of adopters who will adopt nothing but black cats. It's got such a lot of personality.
The one that I adopted from here is
that's
a black
cat. And that cat had a lot of personality.
Yeah, it's too much personality.
Okay, so who do we have snoozing on the bench right here?
That is Bombay.
Hi, Bombay.
Bombay was an owner surrender. He's a very, very sweet boy. He came in with a brother, and his brother got adopted.
Couch potato?
Couch potato, for sure. He's
coming
under two when he needs it, that's for sure.
Excellent. Well, do we know how old he is?
I would go so far as to say he's maybe 11 months.
He's pretty young. He looks pretty snoozy right now, but I seem to remember him running around the room quite a bit.
Oh, yeah. Well, his brother looked almost identical, too. His brother had more of the rambunctious energy. He's definitely a little quieter.
Oh, that's great. Is that Zora Willow in the window there? Zora Willow is a beautiful cat who came to us all the way from Texas. And he's actually one of our longer-term adoptive prospects. He seems to have found a great spot in the sun in the window. Zora Willow is a fairly young cat. I think, is he like 2 or 3? Maybe even younger?
I think it's about a year and a half.
About a year and a half, okay. He's a medium hair black kitty. He's very friendly. He also is good with dogs, and this is one that we know for sure, because Zora Willow traveled from Texas with his dog who got adopted, and they weren't interested in having a kitty. So says, well, Will is still looking for his home. He's been with us about 3 months, and we'd love it if somebody would come in and take a look at him. He's a great cat.
There's kind of a multitude of reasons why the cats are in here. Some of them are surgery candidates that are just waiting to get spayed and neutered. Some of them are recovering from surgery. We do have Mika, who's available, but she's not on the adoption floor because she recently got spayed and we don't want her to jump and rip her sutures. So she's in recovery. It doesn't mean she couldn't go home today if somebody was interested. We also have a few cats in here that are just waiting. Some of them are going tomorrow to get spayed or neutered. And then we have a few cats that sometimes we don't want to put them on the adoption floor because they may not show their personalities the way
they should.
They
may be shy, they might be.
The perfect example is Oscar. Oscar was an owner surrender. He was already neutered. He unfortunately didn't do very well with the kids. I'm not sure how old the kids were. They may have been a little too loud or rambunctious. They may have grabbed at him, pulled on his tail a couple of times, and he just really didn't like it, and he doesn't have a voice to say, hey, stop that. So he's in here because a lot of children enter the adoption floor on a daily basis, and we'd rather not have an incident because kids sometimes don't know that not all cats like to be chased or really loved on. Oscar's a really, really sweet cat and would do really well in a home without children. So this is our feral recovery room. These are cats that have come in that were maybe a little bit on the wild side, who we've rehabilitated and turned into pretty nice cats. You know, if you would have asked me 6 months ago if I thought Darius was gonna let me do this to him, I would have said, oh no, no way, no way. but he's really come a long way. He's still not 100% there, but I think with the right work and dedication, I think he could be a really loving cat. He did come in with what we assumed was his sister litter mate, who's actually in the little bed behind you. They came in together and we had to unfortunately separate them for treatment. They are FIV positive and had some upper respiratory infections that we needed to try and treat to the best of our ability. They've only recently been reunited and are still super, super bonded together, which amazes me. You know, it makes me think that maybe there's a deeper connection than just litter mates there, that maybe they were partners in raising some kittens, maybe he's the father. I don't really know, but for whatever reason, they do really love each other, and I attribute much of his success in this room outside of a cage to her. I think if it wasn't for her, he would not have come around like he did, because he showed vast stretches of improvement after he was introduced to this room with her in it. So he's been doing really well. We try not to push him too far. You know, we take what progress we can get every day. The fact that I can rub the top of his head is just a huge improvement from where he was. And Brandy is, she's a little spitfire. Molly, coming over?
What kind of home would be the best home, Melissa?
If they were gonna get homed, I would say I would want them to go together because I couldn't stand to break them up. You know, they've done so well so far together that I really think that the bond is too strong to separate at this point.
Mm-hmm.
The home that they would do best in is where they are the only cats. They have to be indoor cats. They cannot be indoor, outdoor. FIV is something that could be transmitted to other cats, unfortunately. So it's really in their best interest to stay indoors with a loving family. For Darius's sake, I would say no children. I think, again, the fast movements and the loud noises would really be startling to him. Her, I don't think it would bother as much. She seems to be adaptable to just about everything. But I think Darius still needs some time to adjust.
Mm-hmm. So Darius and Brandy, bonded pair, forever in love, and looking for a good home.
What are you doing? Did you go back? What's she doing? Huh? What's she doing?
They were both feral cats?
Yes.
Yeah, oh my gosh. Yeah. We're going to stick it far down. Say, come on, I want to play.
To ferals is that they get sick while they're here, because then they really get the chance to be treated and handled by humans more frequently, which in turn helps them adapt and adjust and get used to constant contact, which gives them better chances of getting adopted out or going to rescues that will really be able to work with them and help them. Benton's a sweet, sweet boy. He's also FIV positive, so he would have to be an only cat. And I think he would prefer that anyway. He doesn't seem to care too much for other cats.
He says, I sure do like the attention.
He does.
Yeah, what a happy boy.
He'd be happier if he had a home. And you, buddy.
Yeah. Is he finally realizing this catnip there?
Mm-hmm. Oh, he loves catnip.
So I'll just lay here. Turns around to look for you for reassurance. Is she still here?
And of course, don't forget, here at the Humane Society Waterville area, we've always got kittens. If we don't have this little kitten today, we'll have another kitten that looks just like him tomorrow. And we've got more behind these guys ready to go. So it's cat and kitten season. Think about adopting. If you can't support the shelter by adopting, we've got some other ways that you can help out. We always have fundraisers going. We always need money to help take care of these animals while they're looking for their adoptive homes. We have partnered with Hannaford and the Clink Company to do a bottle drive. If you stop into the shelter, we can provide some of these green Clink bags that come with our barcode sticker on them. Take these home, give them to your friends, your family, your neighbors, do a bottle drive. Fill up these green trash bags that have our sticker on them. Take them directly to a Hannaford store. All Hannaford stores have the Clink program that they're partnering with. And the bottles will support the animals here at the Humane Society in Waterville. So they know by this barcode number that the money is to come to us for the returnable. So hoping that you'll be able to stop in and pick up some Clink bags or come in and adopt a furry friend.